Things that I'm glad I brought on my trip to Alaska and things that I really didn't need. So, number one, I'm really glad I brought my vest. The vest that I'm wearing right now. It's something that's light enough for a day that's a bit windy, but not too windy and not wet. And it's really warm. It's really warm. So I just bought this and I'm really, really glad I did. I'm also really, really glad that I bought my binoculars. Of course, you know, when I was on my deck looking at the water, I was able to see some seals and some other mammals. And if I hadn't brought my binoculars, I wouldn't have known what they were. It really helped me to see those little animals that I had heard a lot about. I'm also really, really glad that I bought these pants here. Now, these don't have a zipper at the knee, so they don't make shorts. And honestly, I didn't need shorts anyways. But I'm really, really glad I brought them because I'm able to put them over my leggings. And the truth is that I didn't really need to bring that many pairs of pants because I don't like packing a lot. I did overpack, but I don't like packing a lot, and I find that my pair of leggings, maybe an extra pair of leggings, and these blue pants were fantastic. I'm really glad that I brought my winter jacket because there were some days, some mornings that were really cool, and I enjoy walking around the track. And I needed my jacket on certain days because not so much the mittens, although I did appreciate having them, but the winter jacket was so important. So bring a winter jacket if you ever do a cruise, especially in the fall, because my cruise was in September and it was you know, misty and it was wet, so I brought a rain jacket as well, but the winter jacket was really, really useful as well. And one last thing that I'm really glad that I'm really glad I brought my tablet. Now, I had just bought a new tablet. I don't have it here right now, but it's a Samsung Galaxy 8, something like that. And it's fairly big. It's a lot bigger than my Amazon Fire, but I'm really glad I brought it because there were days that it was like fog and mist, like in Juneau. We couldn't go out. All we had to do was stay in. So yeah, I did some activities on the ship, but you know, I also did a lot of reading when we went to Glacier Bay. This was yesterday, went to Glacier Bay. I really appreciated the sights. But then we started moving along a few hours after, and I ate and I did my activities, but then there were a few hours that I didn't really have anything to do or didn't want to do anything, and I chilled out in my room and of course read. I read and I'm really enjoying this book. One more thing, I am so loving my balcony. I'm really, really loving my balcony. You know, in the last few years, I've traveled in the studios. Now, the studios are great if you are a solo traveler. The rooms are fairly small, but they're comfortable. And you know, what I liked about the studios is that at 5 o'clock every day, we knew that we could meet in that room and just mingle or plan organizations. Plan trips and meals and stuff like that. But this year for my Alaskan cruise, I wanted to have a balcony and no regrets. So I'm paying a little bit more, but no regrets. And if you are a solo traveler, I'm on the Bliss right now. It is, you are able to meet in the studios, which is where the solo travelers are. You're able to meet, it's announced on one of those documents. And although I'm not in a studio, I was able to meet up with other solo travelers and plan some activities around them. So that was really good. By the way, solo travelers are individuals that are traveling by themselves. And I think that if you are, two women traveling alone, you can get a studio as well. But it's mostly not necessarily singles, but it's for people who are alone traveling. So there might be a husband that didn't want to go with his wife, and so she's booked a studio. I'm by myself. I'm single, and I was also traveling by myself, so that worked out really well. And so those are things that that I really, really appreciated. Now let's talk about the things that I didn't like or that I didn't really need to bring. Now I'm wondering if I needed to really bring a second pair of shoes. Well, actually more than that, because I got my flip-flops, I got my dressier shoes, I've got my running shoes, and I got my hiking boots. And I'm not sure. Today I'm going to test out my hiking boots. I have worn them a couple of times, but I think, and I'll chime in later, I think I might have gotten away with maybe not bringing the running shoes or not bringing the hiking shoes. Well, I'll let you know a little bit more about that. The other thing that I really didn't need to bring was a lot of clothes. Honestly, I want to travel light. I tend to maybe wear the same clothes or interchange the clothes. I've been wearing my leggings, and it's not like somebody's going to say, "Oh, you're wearing the same leggings every day." No, I've brought different tops, but I think I brought way too much clothes. I'm on an Alaskan cruise. I wore a dress once with my black leggings underneath. It's one of those Amazon dresses that I love so much. So I think I brought way too much clothes. I'm going to look at my. Yeah, I brought some tops and I brought some pink shorts that I haven't worn that I won't wear. I brought some other gray shorts that I'm not going to need at all. So you don't really need to pack that much. I'm glad that I've got my rain jacket, although I tended to stay inside when it was raining. I tried it on just to see if it fits good, but and thus far I haven't used it. Now I do have it packed in my bag because I am going on a hike today, so I'm going to bring it with me because I think it's looks like it's raining a tad. So I'll have it with me just in case. It's one of those things that you bring with you just in case. Another thing that I didn't really like at all, of course, was I need to add that one thing that I'm so glad that I brought with me is my shawl. I put it over my shoulders, and it was so good for the deck. So, when I think about it, some of the things that I bought, I'm really glad I did. But there's other things that, that I didn't really need. For example, I can't think of anything else. So, I think, this overpacking is always a big issue for a lot of people. Like for me, I brought way too much clothes, and the things that I did bring that I used a lot were my shawl. My winter jacket was awesome. My blue pants were awesome. Those were really, really important. So that's it. If you are going on an Alaskan cruise, one last thing. It is true that the weather is unpredictable. When we were in Glacier Bay, when we arrived there was a little bit of mist, and then it lifted, and then it just gave us a perfect opportunity.